Rain Day. Meanwhile, you're back and casting some NA Apex Legends for the first time in a few months. Nail, Jess, good to have you back, my man. How much are you looking forward to NA?
Oh, so much. Especially, I mean, what a debut. You know, the scene has been buzzing lately amongst Twitter of what's happening, where are things headed, what can we expect? Well, that's what makes it so fun and why you shouldn't really go anywhere during most of this broadcast. We're going to find out right now. And Vicky, Fallout, and I, as well as Ash and James, get to guide you through the action. It's a great day.
You hit the nail on the head. So there's a lot to talk about, a lot to break down, a lot to get excited for with this matchup, Group A versus Group D. But
Day 2 of Week 4 of North American Pro League. So, Esports Arena, who has 25 points, pretty much already qualified for LAN. TSM has 14 points. So, today being the last day with Snipedown's head kind of in Halo-verse, TSM needs to have a good day today. They need to drop a top 3 placement today to remain competitive to get to LAN. If TSM shits the bed today, they'll be playing with Verholst, a new third with no chemistry for the final 2 weeks to potentially qualify for LAN. Huge day for TSM. Arguably one of the biggest tournament days for them ever. Lots on the line.
If Verholst coming to TSM, if that's true, that again makes sense. I think this is a smart decision. If Verholst does this, if Verholst actually does, I will not blame him. I don't think his friends, I guarantee you, are speaking from frustration, which you have to understand. I'd be so frustrated because we're winning and we're doing well. We're outperforming TSM.
But speaking of cast and games, we got game number one ready. We mentioned it at the top of the show, but certainly a drama-filled, a highly entertaining-filled broadcast about to come at you live. A lot of speculation right now. Who knows what the future holds for Snipedown and TSM as they'll be competing today. That's one thing we know for sure.
This is an awkward drop. Fuck, I don't even think I'm gonna make it.
Just land on the balloon if you have to. Yep.
Bro, they sound so sad.
Your zone goes.
Yeah, I'm. Oh shit, I dropped.
Lava Siphon or Hearth.
Hearth, probably.
Verhulst, the Lutex's coming to you.
Okay.
I don't think there is a vault team.
They're like, either there or down low.
I just right got my Prowler in literally deeper spot. Should be fine though.
Should be fine.
Are we playing for Siphon Beacon?
Spitfire.
What'd you get?
Spitfire and a Digi. Playing the roof head glitch.
They're getting pinched. Gibby fried. Gibby bubbed at the bat.
One is blue on the top roof.
Getting pinched. They're in bad A. They're getting fucked.
Bye bye. Oh, it's the whole team.
I'm ulting them. Push up on me, please.
Push up on this.
That'd be thermites, I think.
Can we get a bag res?
I already bumped.
I'm 1 HP. They're picking up. I have no knock, I don't have it.
I'm running. I knew that shit was gonna happen.
Alright.
I'm IGLing
every single game from now on. I don't know why we didn't push up when we made the Gibby bubble too.
We got Rick starting.
There is a team here. I think if you last hit all of them and they die in zone, you get the kills
sure
maybe.
Make sure you're in zone first. You might not be in zone.
You're good.
No, you're not. You have to take a tick of zone too, and then make your right there. You might have to just run around.
I'm just running around.
You got this. Nah, damn it.
Nope. I just got a dead slide. Dude. Ha!
Towards construction. Find after construction. I hit her 90 purple.
It's a duo.
It's a duo. I think we look to kill this.
Just respawn. Let's fuck all.
I'm coming. Oh, fuck. I'm so fucking.
You're good. We'll still have time. It's going to be a cat and mouse chase in this building, though.
Land on height.
They're gonna instant kill you.
Bro.
Wraith one.
Fuck. I don't think that was the play.
Getting shot at though.
I think you're chilling. Hug the corner more. Go back in the corner.
Don't move. I see him.
I don't know what to do there.
That's right. I just saw you, I guess. Just know we support you as a person, all right, bro?
Yeah, you're our friend.
That's good to hear. I'm gonna.
It's just as a competitor.
Mm-hmm.
I just felt a little insulted. That's it. All right, bro.
I know. I totally after. Understand.
We got Gibby ulted.
Valkyrie won. I got the Valkyrie. I'm gonna die to this Gibby ult, I think.
We're getting fucking pulled up on our back for Holes. On the right.
I'm armor swapping.
I'm behind us, yeah. On us. Use me.
They're rezzing.
Duck dead. Gibby cracked.
I have to swap.
Gibby's slow. He's one shot.
I got a bat.
Bring me up to the rock. It's the Gibby. I'm doing the rock.
Bob up. You listen to dude. Bob up. There's a shield top on
the top. I saw one. Okay. I got it.
Bloodhound's one. Last Gibby's last.
Let's go,
let's
boys.
Fucking go, boys.
We still have a shadow winning this. I'm a pop nigga like people.
I don't fuck bitches, I'm queer. But these nigga bitches like. I'm bumping up.
I'm batting.
Bro, I ulted on them. They're just in play slow. Don't go down for holes. Dropping in the bub.
Half dead.
Hit the shield swap.
I got one. I'm up.
It's fine.
We're not gonna get it in time, I don't think.
It's fine. Stop it.
Fight him!
I have to heal. They're up there?
Yeah. 50 flush on one. I'm at the bub up, dude.
Run up. Get up underneath them and arc them.
Watch the left side.
Verhulst, just try. Beamed.
I can't climb.
She's super weak. We're not.
They're all floating out. The full team under a rock.
Get steal kills, guys.
There's a dude behind us still, I think.
We're fine. I'm moving up.
I got Valk.
Alright.
Behind. One guy behind. I've knocked him.
He's one.
I'm dead. We should have killed the guy behind us.
I didn't know he was there. What should we play?
That's okay.
I don't clear up rumors. Where's y'all sense
of humor? I'm done making jokes because they got. I think I hear him. Yeah. 40 on one behind the crate. Almost cracked. Give me one. Valcrack. They're both two of them are still low. I'm watching north. They're at the harvester roost.
They asked out. We're holding get healthy.
I'm sitting in this corner. They're all dead. I almost cracked Ash. They portaled somewhere.
Hey, Ash TP above on the box. I'm ulting it. Careful.
I almost cracked two.
I cracked Ash.
Ash one, Ash dead. Blood one.
Shield swap, boys. Try the swap.
I'm resing. Watch for north.
Climb up.
You're good.
Field cell, so he's going to have to trade a little bit of time, maybe for a little bit of efficiency if it gets down to it. He's got 13 of those, so it shouldn't be a problem. But now, Vicky, things are starting to close, and this is going to tell a lot for Esports Arena if they can continue to somehow find the angles there. You can see Verhulst is ready to shoot.
Ooh. And he didn't even take damage just yet from the circle. Now they're forced to go through this open ground, but they did get that crack, so they're forced to play this a lot more defensively.
Oh, nice.
Great crack from Verhulst there, and yeah, the Archstar, too, trying to deny them the space. They're playing at a circle. They're already low as it is. They close out the KP, they move forward, and they're going to also get to the cover behind this truck.
Oh man, these guys just don't miss sometimes, but it doesn't matter. Sometimes there's just not enough you can do, not enough shield, not enough space, and not enough damage, but what? Verhulst! He finds it somehow. He turns into the kill leader, and he is alive. I told you 2.5 seconds might be all he needs, and he does. He gets 100 shield back. He's got to move, though, because he's only got one health. The ring is his biggest opponent right here. 5 squads left. Can Duplex and Verhulst come through? They can, and they find not only shield swaps, not that Verhulst needs it, but the ability to get Skittle Cakes up and full heal. What did I just see, Vicky?
Ellie, they're nading us.
Hey, get up under the hill.
Where's Wook safe right here, girls?
They're swinging us. Use Bub when you have it, probably.
I'm marking them.
I cracked one.
Flash.
Seconds on Bub!
Flame or not?
They're getting shot. I think one of them might have went down. I'm not sure. Is it a rat up here?
Just heal.
Shoot the rat.
Full heal, Skittles. Just full heal. Bob in 15. I only have one bat.
I have no nades. I only have 3 bats.
Here's bats. And I'm dropping a thermite for you.
I grabbed it.
Shoot the Valk up top. Get.
I stunned all three.
Good team.
They're in shambles. They both.
I'm ulting that. I got my ult. Let me ult.
They ulted us as well. They ulted us.
Don't die from the height. Do not die from height.
Great arc stars.
Knock one.
God damn.
Knock two.
Bro, his Prowler looks bullets are like magnetized. Like they just shit on.
I need energy ammo.
I don't have any. Don't have any.
I ulted high. They're fighting.
Knocked one.
Swing to the right.
Will TSM be able to stop Esports? No, look at this. They are full shield. 2 EVOs, 1 gold. This team has taken North America by storm and are supplanting the greats, the heroes of times past. It is a new time. It is a new hero. It is Esports Arena who are going to be your champions here in Game 5 of Apex Legends North America.
ESA are insane. mean, Verhulst is the aim god. What a performance from ESA. They had to play in the most worst position where they had to literally put themselves in between three squads, and they still came out on top. Rain, how is that possible? How, when they lost two members to Space Station, did they manage to restabilize? What was that from ESA?
Skittlecakes goes in with a devotion, and no players on the enemy team come out. It's like the new walks into a bar joke. I don't know how they keep doing it, but they do. And 27 points, our biggest total, not just in North America, but on the day. You just saw it, ladies and gentlemen. A little slice of history, a little piece of greatness, a little moment of excellence from Esports Arena and the young stars who are, well, they're playing like old, experienced veterans right now, teaching everybody else in this lobby a lesson, Vicky.
I'm good here for now.
Should be dead, under us.
Just heal!
We gotta move. I'm safe.
Marking behind that. Oh, they're on top of us, right on top of us.
I have to bat.
I'm batting as well. No, I'm dead in the zone. What am I knock? Let me know if you're gonna move. I'm holding left. Pushing up.
Definitely not the play.
Three. Can I get a bat?
I got 2 cells, I have 5 cells.
You have
to walk up soon.
You don't have anything, right? You don't have anything?
Alex, you have to walk up and take angles.
Not yet. You have to wait. You have to go now, actually.
Go. You're in trouble.
We're dead. Like, come on!
View. Nowhere to be seen.
They're in 18th. They died before.
TSM got no kills.
Let's go.
Love to see it, boys.
Let's fucking go, boys. Love to see it. Fucking first.
Thank you for finishing out strong with us, Verhulst.
Yes, sir. Yes.
Couldn't have asked more from you.
We officially won that one. Yes, sir, baby. Yes,
let's go, sir. Boys.
Yes, sir, baby. Let's fucking get it, boys.
Well, there you have it. Some standout players today, certainly for this rendition of your ALGS Monster MVP. Some great performers, some great team efforts, as we saw ESA dominate this one, barely inching out over TSM, but against the rest of the lobby, they looked so incredibly strong. TSM went second place, G2 behind them in third overall. So I just want to have a quick discussion, one quick thought from each of y'all. What does this mean for the grand scheme of things? I mean, ESA continues to perform week in and week out. Vicky, do you really think they can continue the success going into the split playoffs?
Yeah, I'm looking at teams like ESA, Sentinels, NRG are really consistent squads that have maintained their spot in the top portion of the leaderboards. I think they're definitely going to still continue on this momentum, but who knows, Faldo? Who knows what kind of news we're going to expect throughout the course of this upcoming week? We'll have to see, but that is going to trickle down to whether we're going to have ESA still top out those leaderboards.
Yeah, well, maybe we'll hear a little bit more about that individual's future. Guess what? We talked about the Monster MVP and standout player, at least for James here. It was Verhulst, the controller player who played so incredibly well. Young man, 18-year-old, who has been dominating, really rising as a star here in the ALGS Season 2. We got Rain Day live and ready for an interview with the man himself. It's Verhulst.
We are live and ready. That's right, John, for an interview with the man, the myth, the legend, Verhulst. Good to be talking to you. Also, we got two Evans on the screen. The first time in ALDS history. I feel like this is a momentous occasion. Hey, it's good to talk to you, Evan Verhulst. You know, you can buy your last name here. I just want to start off with this, man. You know, you are 18 years old. Obviously, you guys took today as the number one team, Esports Arena. Talk to us, though, for those who don't know you, who haven't followed your career and that much. You know, obviously, you're 18. There hasn't been enough of it for most people to follow for 10 years. You would have had to start when you were 8 years old. At this point, who are you? Let us know a little bit about you, where you came from, how you got to this moment.
I've been playing video games my whole life. I have three older brothers, and they all played FPS games, and they kind of got me into it at an early age. So, like, I was playing COD 4, I think, was the first FPS game I played when I was, like four or five years old at the time when it first came out. And, like, I played all the CODs leading up to Apex, just all throughout my life, played FPS games. Wow. And then I found Apex, and I remember, like, it was, like, a spring break. It was a spring break during school, and I was playing so much Apex, and I was so bored. And I was like, I got to make something out of this. And so I remember I looked up online for, like, tournaments, and I started playing in, like, little small kill race tournaments and started doing well, and that's where it all started. And, you know, I only recently started competing in ALGS about 4 or 5 months ago. But up until that, I was playing a lot of kill race tournaments, grinding the game every single day, and, you know, just always trying to improve every single day.
So did you find that out? Because it came out in February, surprise launch. So spring break's got to be a month or so after that. So were you basically season one, and you started saying, hey, this is kind of fun. All right, Apex, that surprise launch, it might have gotten you one of your brightest stars here, especially during spring break. Let all those game developers know about that. But listen, walk me through, Evan, one of those moments that I found iconic, casting it, that Vicky and James and the rest of us were going crazy in TeamSpeak typing about, that Game 5 moment. Were you able to clutch it up? You had about 5 health to your name with the Prowler, doing so much work and able to walk through and ultimately win that game against SSG, TSM, Buff Pathfinder, all in that lobby in considerably advantageous spots. Walk me through, you know, your experience kind of clutching up there.
It was crazy. There is so much going on there. Like, I couldn't really think about anything when that was happening. I was just, like, basically trusting my instincts. I was just, you know, nothing to think about at that point. Just aim and shoot, stay alive. That's all there is to it. Just play my life. I was just trying to keep my team alive on the rotate in. Just shot at everything that I saw. Tried to just use cover. I mean, there wasn't too much strategy behind it other than literally just shoot and stay alive. That's, like, the only thing that I was thinking about. And, you know, I was so happy to have made it, rotated out of there, and then our full team got the reset. It felt great. It was amazing.
Well, you know, that's kind of the funny thing. We talk about you as the mechanical genius on the controller, but there's also this sense of calm. There's this sense of, trust, and there's this beautiful synergy that you guys have on Esports Arena. Talk to me how you were able to cultivate such a nice environment for you guys to really not have too much going on within the comms and just, you know, trust you're going to make the right play.
I think we all understand each other, like, extremely well. We all understand our personalities really well. We vibe together well, and, you know, we've been playing for enough time to build some solid synergy. And I think part of it kind of came naturally. Like, I remember our very first time playing ranked together, we just popped off. Like, we just had an insane ranked session. We just dominated for, like, the first week of playing together. And it's like, we all knew right away that we worked well together. So I think there was a little natural synergy there, but I think we're all that natural synergy comes from all three of us being incredible, you know, mechanical, like, strategic players. And, you know, we all just work together well.
Well, Evan, I only got you here for one more question. So I'm going to ask what a lot of people, I'm sure, in chat and across online, Twitter, Reddit, have been wondering about you. Your name has come up in a lot of speculation over the course of this last week. I'm not exactly going to name it, but I'm going to let you give us what you want to give us. What can you say about your future personally and the future of Esports Arena heading forward in the ALGS?
Oh, man. Stay tuned, boys. Stay tuned. Got big things coming. Big things coming. That's about all I can say.
All right. Well, I think that will sate the appetites of many watching and only add fuel to the fire. Evan, it's a pleasure to grace the screen with another Evan Verhulst. Congratulations on your win today and your performance thus far, man. You got a bright future in Apex. All right, that's it. Evan Verhulst with Rain Day here, closing it out for Game 6. Thanks, John. Go ahead and take it away. Baby bet, a couple racks, a couple Grammys on him.